How can you tell if it's pride or pandering? Show off your pride with all new shirts, water bottles, hoodies, and more. Only available for a limited time on the PBR merchandise store. Linked in the description down below. Welcome everyone to Power Brainbows. I'm of course your host, Professor Pride. And on today's show, we're showing you some different ways to tell if a company or organization is just pandering to the LGBTQ community for profit, or if they are showing genuine support. But before we begin, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Anyway, onto the show. This Pride season, you will inevitably see companies and organizations changing their logos on social media to one including rainbows. You might see companies sponsoring floats and Pride parades, and you'll more than likely see Pride merchandise on the shelves of many different stores in your hometown, if you live in an accepting country, that is. That's partly because 24% of internet users in the United States alone are more likely to do business with companies known to be LGBTQ friendly. In our community, gays and lesbians are 71% more likely to do business with a company shown to be LGBTQ friendly. Bisexuals are 54% more likely, millennials are 32% more likely, and high income earners are 34% more likely. And it needs to be said that seeing this support is wonderful. I mean, 50 years ago, Pride merchandise didn't even exist, and seeing LGBTQ merchandise on the shelves of your local general store, like Walmart, would have been severely damaging to that company's bottom line 50 years ago. But now the support for our community has luckily shifted, and now companies who show support for our community are supported by not just the LGBTQ, but the overall population for showing that support. In fact, in a 2019 report, they found that 76% of consumers want CEOs of major corporations to take the lead on change instead of waiting for the government to impose that change. That's why certain companies have now raised their minimum wages ahead of the United States government, forcing them to do that, because consumers wanted these companies to take a stand and wanted CEOs to act first. But while this support is fantastic to see, no doubt, the truth is some companies do not care about the LGBTQ community. They only put rainbows on advertisements as a new marketing strategy, and they see this as a quick way to make a quick buck and then leave our community high and dry on July 1st when Pride Month is over, and the money by then is already in their pocket. For example, back in 2018, Adidas sold a Rainbow Pride collection for their shoes, but then they spent millions of dollars in Russia as a major sponsor of the 2018 World Cup, helping Russia with their anti-LGBTQ laws and helping make the country unsafe for fans and athletes. The apparel line called Pink from Victoria's Secret tweeted their support for the LGBTQ community, but then refused to allow transgender models to be included in their annual fashion show. And sadly, there are plenty more examples we can give here. So today, we're going to give you a simple test that you can put on any company or organization to see if they are truly allies of our community or if they are just pandering to make a quick buck. And for the record, we even welcome you to put this test up against our parent company, Madhasm Productions, which runs this YouTube channel, to see if we are LGBTQ friendly before going to our merchandise store and buying something rainbow for Pride Month. Speaking of which, we have new items that are only going to be available for a limited time, so go check them out now. But before we get to this test, for any executives of organizations or companies out there who are looking to show genuine support for our community and maybe looking to make a little profit as well, we have an entire episode dedicated to showing you 25 tips to attract LGBTQ customers and to help you pass the test we are about to give. The first question you should ask as a consumer before buying anything rainbow or from a Pride collection in a store or online is, where does the money actually go? Any company which is genuine in their support for the LGBTQ community will have some signage or banner on their social media telling you that a portion of their proceeds from that merchandise is going to an LGBTQ charity or cause. For example, HBO and Last Week Tonight with John Oliver recently put out a book called Marlon Bundo. It's a children's book all about Mike Pence's bunny being a gay bunny. But more importantly here, the first line of their description on Amazon says 100% of Last Week Tonight's proceeds will be donated to the Trevor Project and AIDS United, both of which are LGBTQ-friendly charities. Any company which is genuine in their support will have some sort of disclaimer or signage showcasing this proceed donation. In other words, they aren't just looking for a profit, but they are willing to donate some of their profits back to the community. This won't always be 100%, but most companies will at least give 10 to 20% of their proceeds back to the LGBTQ community. And for the record, here at MHP, from our merchandise store for this show, 100% of the proceeds from those items goes to helping make more LGBTQ educational content here on our channel, in helping us buy hard drives, backdrops, and pay for gas to get to different Pride events so we can meet all of you beautiful people in person and film all of those Pride events for you to enjoy online. Plus, we regularly donate as much as we can to the Trevor Project Crisis Intervention and Suicide Prevention Hotline for LGBTQ youth. The second question you should always ask is, how long have they been supporters? Check their social media last year to see if their Pride suddenly ended on July 1st, when Pride Month was over. Sure, they could have just started a new campaign, but that just shows you that their Pride was really just a marketing campaign in the first place, because they simply just moved on to the next campaign on July 1st. The truth is, if you want to support a company for their LGBTQ support, then you should only support the companies willing to showcase their Pride year-round. For example, a company called Spencer's Gifts sells LGBTQ Pride merchandise year-round and has tons of LGBTQ-friendly messages year-round. So they aren't just pandering to make a quick buck and move on. They are always here for our community 365 days a year. And for the record, our parent company offers multiple LGBTQ channels on YouTube, including this one, and offers 150 episodes every year for the education of LGBTQ topics. Even if a company doesn't offer LGBTQ items in their merchandise year-round, and even if they don't have a rainbow in their profile picture year-round, they can still be LGBTQ-friendly and worthy of your hard-earned dollars. But the next questions to ask are there LGBTQ individuals represented in their campaigns year-round? And if they ever got backlash for showcasing someone in the LGBTQ community in their ads, how did they respond to it? For example, Netflix got a ton of backlash for including LGBTQ characters in almost every original show they have. But they responded by saying, quote, "Sorry, you have yet to realize that every gay person is very necessary." And even Amazon Prime responded with a similar message. So while Netflix doesn't have a rainbow on their profile all year round, they do show their support in everything they do year round. And now on to some harder questions to answer. While some of these you won't be able to answer while standing in the aisle of your local store, if you do a tiny bit of research online before going to the store, you can find all of this out quite easily. So the next question is, how is the LGBTQ employee experience at that company? Does that company protect LGBTQ workers from discrimination in their company policies? Do they allow employees to wear rainbows in their store? Or has there ever been any reports of that company firing their employees or throwing customers out of their store for being LGBTQ? This is just a Google search away at your fingertips. For example, at a TV station I work for, they allowed me to wear a rainbow face mask this entire pandemic while I'm out filming events for them. And they even fired another employee on my behalf after he called me homophobic slurs. That report is made public online, and now other employees can feel safer in working there. But to contrast this, another example we can use is Hobby Lobby, who regularly discriminates against LGBTQ customers and employees. The records of those court cases and so on are public record and made national news, so it discourages people from buying in their stores. The next question you should ask is, does the company refuse to do business in countries or states with anti-LGBTQ laws? Now, this question might be harder to answer for smaller companies that only have one or a few locations, but for major companies, this becomes a major issue. For example, one of the largest ads you might see this Pride season is from a company called Walmart. Sure, they will put rainbow merchandise in their stores for you to buy, and sure, they will market themselves as this massively supportive company which helps protect LGBTQ workers with their endless commercials. but they have stores in Russia, Ukraine, and even buy many of the items they sell in their stores from China, all of which are anti-LGBTQ countries with horrible anti-LGBTQ laws. Another great example is one from Netflix, who pulled an entire show's production from North Carolina after the state passed an anti-LGBTQ law. In many of these cases, yes, money talks, but actions speak louder than words. Sure, it's nice to hear a company supports the community on June 1st when all of these companies schedule social media posts with rainbows, but in January of 2019, Netflix decided to put their money where their mouth is and move an entire multi-million dollar production because lawmakers there didn't deserve the tax income. Next is a harder question to answer, but one that you can find the answer to with a simple Google search. Are there equitable benefits for LGBTQ workers, including for domestic partnership benefits, transgender inclusive benefits, and so on? In other words, do they support not just our sexuality and gender, but are they willing to help their employees get the benefits they need to affirm that gender or sexuality? The next question you should ask yourself is, has the company used its political influence to sponsor bills that offer LGBTQ protection? For example here, Chick-fil-A used to donate millions of dollars every year to anti-LGBTQ hate groups and sponsor bills to allow discrimination against LGBTQ people. They have since backtracked on this publicly, but according to new reports, now their corporate officers make a few million dollars more per year, and these hate groups have a sizable check coming from personal donations now instead of a company. On the other hand, Tesla, Delta Airlines, Amazon, Pepsi, General Motors, and more have spent millions sponsoring the Equality Act to protect LGBTQ people in America. For the record, before I got the COVID-19 vaccine, I checked to see if the company making the vaccine was an LGBTQ supporter, and Pfizer is a proud sponsor of the Equality Act, so I was comfortable getting that vaccine over the other companies. Another thing to note is that all three vehicles my company owns are made by General Motors, and the computers we use to write and edit this show from are Apple computers, who both spent millions of dollars sponsoring the Equality Act. So for companies who are genuine supporters of the LGBTQ community, it doesn't just mean we're donating to LGBTQ causes ourselves, but it matters to us who we do business and associate with to ensure they are doing the same. Finally, ask yourself if they have any LGBTQ executives on their board of directors. This isn't always necessary, but it is nice to see that representation at a corporate level, and sort of ensures they are not discriminating against LGBTQ workers, and shows you they have the community in mind when making major moves. For example, Apple's current CEO is a gay man named Tim Cook, and that's another reason we are comfortable purchasing Apple computers to write and edit this show on. When it comes to this test, you won't always see a company answering correctly to every question. Even if they get one or two answers wrong, they can still be worthy of your hard-earned dollars, because they are still LGBTQ friendly. They just aren't perfect yet, which honestly, we can't blame them for. Even if they did support us years ago, they couldn't showcase that publicly without backlash. So we have to give them time to get it right here. But for other companies, which just started or boomed in the past 50 years, there is no excuse why they shouldn't answer correctly to all of these questions. Please remember here, there are hundreds of companies and organizations selling Pride merchandise or asking for your hard-earned dollars this Pride Month, so there's plenty of competition to go around. Without putting this test on every organization you give your money to, whether in donations or for a product or service in return, remember, they have to pass with at least an 80% on this test in order to be worthy of those dollars. Otherwise, you're helping to encourage a marketing strategy that is just pandering to our community, slapping rainbows on things, making a quick buck, and then leaving our community high and dry come July 1st. It's so popular among corporations that it even has its own name, called rainbow washing. And for the record, I do encourage you to put this test on my company before you buy any merchandise from our store or become a member of our channel to see exclusive behind-the-scenes content and bloopers from every episode. I assure you, our parent company, Madhasm Productions, our broadcaster, MHP TV, and our show, Powered by Rainbows, passed this test with a 100% score. Otherwise, we wouldn't be worthy of your hard-earned dollars, or even your time, listening to what we have to say on this issue. Anyway, that's all for our episode today. If you have any tips you think we missed, please leave them in the comments down below so others can learn from those tips as well. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video, comment down below your LGBTQ-friendly thoughts, hit that rainbow subscribe button so you don't miss out on new episodes of the show, and share this video with others. As always, I'm your host, Professor Pride. This has been PBR. Have a gay day, everyone, and bye for now.